Problem number 12, solving radical equations. So we have the square root of x minus 3 equals 1 plus the square root of x minus 10. On this side, the radical is already isolated, so we can use the power rule to eliminate the radical. The index is 2, so we are going to raise both sides to the power of 2. On the left side, the radical and the power cancel out. We are left with x minus 3. And on the right side, we actually have to do some work. And I prefer to write it twice because it's really hard to do it in your head. Some people could, but others just making mistakes if they're trying to use shortcuts. So I'm going to write it out. And then I'm going to use FOIL to solve the right side. I have x minus 3 and then first times first, so 1 times 1 is 1. 1 times the square root of x minus 10 is the square root of x minus 10. And then the second times the first, so again the square root of x minus 10. And then the second times the second. So now I would get x minus 10 twice. And again here the index and the power cancel each other out. So let me rewrite this. And also I can combine these two terms. They are like terms. When the radicands are the same, I just add the coefficients in front, and in this case I have an imaginary 1 and an imaginary 1. So now I get 1 and then plus 1 plus 1, which is 2, the radical of x minus 10. And then here the only thing I'm left with is x minus 10. Just going to bring my right side down. Now I still have a radical in this problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to isolate that radical so I can use the power rule again. Let me start by combining like terms on each side. And I have x minus 3 equals 1 minus 10, which is negative 9, plus 2 the radical of x minus 10 plus x. So the only thing I need on this side is this, which means I'm going to start adding 9 to both sides. And I get x plus 6 equals 2 radical of x minus 10 plus x. So I'm going to subtract x from both sides, and I'm left with 6 equals 2 square root of x minus 10. Last step to divide by 2 on both sides, and I have 3 equals the radical of x minus 10. Now I got the radical all by itself, and this is an index of 2, so I can use the power of 2 on both sides. On the right side, the square root and the square cancel out, and on the left side I have 3 raised to the second power, so 3 times 3 is 9, which is equal to x minus 10. Solving for x, so adding 10 to both sides, and we have x equals 19. Now just to make sure we did a lot of work that we do have the correct answer, we have to check that our solution gives us a true statement, so we are going to plug the 19 back into the original problem. So the square root of 19 minus 3 is equal to 1 plus the square root of 19 minus 10. 19 minus 3 gives us 16 equal to 1 plus, and 19 minus 10 is 9. Square root of 16 is 4, and 1 plus square root of 9 is 3. So 4 is equal to 4, which is a true statement. So therefore, x equals 19 is the correct answer for this problem.